every time I am invited to talk as a guest or as a resource person, there is always a prepared speech for me by the presidential management staff. And it is good English, grammatically superior, but it does not come from my heart. That is why I am always in a quandary whether to follow. You know, I can finish this in a minute and a half, so I have to say goodbye. Because I have to go to. So, ganito na lang. Kilala naman ninyo lahat nandito. Let me just talk about our country, the Philippines. I just came from Bohol because there's an ASEAN meet there. And, you know, there was also terrorism that was encountered by the security forces. And we are in a bind because the local criminals are in cahoots or have had connections with the Abu Sayyaf in Jolo and Zamboanga. At ang nangyayari dito is they kidnap itong mga small time lang dito. Those who do not want really to be carrying the kidnapped victim. So they sell them to another group which is bigger, and eventually selling it to the group in Mindanao, and then you have a problem. That is why it was very lucky indeed that the ISIS was, or a group of ISIS who were there, particularly led by Rami, yung spokesman ng Abu Sayyaf na yung maingay na mayabang, eh, kasali siya doon. The soldier who killed him also was killed in the process. It was a duel shootout. So that when I came back from the Middle East, it was the other day, I arrived at 3 o'clock in the morning. Nagkape na lang ako, then I went to see the, tumunta ako sa wake sa sundalo. And it was really very poignant because I for the first time, I laid a gold cross. Hindi lahat ng sundalo makakuha ng ganon. It was a gold cross that was awarded to him. And there's always a time when I visit itong mga patay na ano, I usually make a salute to honor the guy who has served the country. Ang problema natin dito ngayon is coming from the heart, actually. My grandmother, hindi kasi alam ng lahat, si Moro, si Maranao. My grandfather was a Chinese, but ang papa ko from Cebu City, Danao. So I'm talking to you now about our country and what ails this country. Marami po, but let us begin with the yung rebellion, medyo tabi ko na lang muna. There are so many things which you can really do or go into to improve our country. Alam mo, motion pictures mirrors life, or life mirrors the movies. Ganon yan. So it behooves upon you really to do the social aspect of what's happening to our country. Ako po itong tumakbo ng presidente, I made no great promises. I said that I would want to stop corruption. And I'm doing it almost every day. I have fired so many government officials, about 96 of them, but hindi ko na lang inano, I did not make it public because, you know, when I read the dossier, some of them, their sons and daughters were all doctors and lawyers, and, you know, I would not want to add to the embarrassment of just taken away from your office, ousted, and suffer yung publicity of corruption. But corruption is out. Kaya kayong mga Pilipino, kayong talagang Pilipino na gusto ninyong tumulong sa bayan ninyo, now is the time to do it. Really. Kasi ako, I've been, reforming the, just what, 10 months plus. I need time. I need time to remove corruption. Karamihan dyan sa gobyerno, yung their salaries are just the sort of stipend. It's just a side income. But corruption is the main source of income. So I had to lecture to everybody that, you know, during this time, maybe for 5 years and a few months, sa una ko, you have to change your lifestyle. Maybe before, you could have a take of 1,000 every day, and you can buy a new car, a new house, almost every day, every week. But this time, we'll just have to suffer because I'm not a great man. I do not have the credentials. I am not even an honor student. I have always been in the vicinity of 75, 78 since kindergarten. Hanggang dyan lang po ako. So wala akong pinagyayabang except that I was a prosecutor for 9 years, a trial fiscal. Then I became a vice mayor, then rumbled on to become the mayor, and I became the mayor for the last 23 years sa Davao City. Hindi ako nakatikim ng talo, and maybe because I was really, it's not that I am the cleanest or a clean guy. I have so many faults, plenty. But corruption is not one of them. Goro, babae, o ano, pero yung, when you are young, but I'm really old now, so it's almost passé to be talking about it. Well, ang akin lang is corruption must go. And we are good at collecting taxes now. Ayaw ko sanang i-ano dito, bitawan. But look at the oligarchs of the Philippines. Kaya ako galit talaga. I do not mean to, wala naman mawala sa akin. I won the presidency by, 15,006 of which million was my majority over my last opponent. So wala na ako, I'm not angry at anybody. I just want to work. I do not need the adulation. Sabi nga ni ma'am, sabi niya, you were right. I declined yung bigyan nila ako ng honoris causa. I don't need it. It has always been my policy, both as personal and official, that I do not accept awards or honor. That has always been my policy. As for that, in terms of my work, I've always said that I am paid to do it. So why should you receive me? Why should you give me so many awards? Bayad na ako eh. So wala nang, akin lang is yung tamang trabaho lang po sana at maibigay talaga sa Pilipino yung pera nila. But I have a problem in this. Ayaw kong gustong ma-insulto. Pero yung mile long tantawag nila dyan sa Makati, It was owned by the government. And it is now in the name of Sanbar. And they owe government something like 1.6 billion. That was a case that was filed several years ago. Until now, it's still in the Supreme Court. Back to a litigation. Because at that time, Kim Minares, the BIR, whom I hindi ko talaga alam, ay kaibigan ko, ang laki ng respeto ko kay Minares, I even helped her in the campaign sa tax collection sa Davao. Only to realize that talagang ang problem sa Pilipinas, it is the oligarchy. So I can force people to pay taxes. For the Chinese businessmen to be arrested and make the demands. Pero itong mga mayaman, not because they have been attacking me. Eh matagal na ako sa politika, that's nothing to me. That's my daily bread yung mga ganun. But how in the hell can they manage to, you know, skirt and just ignore the law? From 1 billion plus, naging 800 million lang. And ang naggumawa si Kim Minares. So it was, there was a case, and the case is now, for the longest time, nasa Supreme Court. And I really do not know what's keeping the Supreme Court from deciding a simple case of back taxes. And the land, yung tawag na the mile, yung may canal dyan, Makate, it's owned by the government. But it was paid for a song. At nobody has questioned it, nobody will. Eh sabi ko, hindi naman ako gumagante, pero kaibigan man kita o hindi, magbayad ka talaga. Saan na ba ako ganun? Bayad ka. Wala akong pakialam ng kaibigan tayo at hindi. Let's just pay your taxes. Pay the right amount and we have no problem. Ganun ako. And alam ko sino may-ari niyan. Dunkin' Donut of the government on 1,600,000. Is the Inquirer, itong Inquirer, when they editorialize you, moaning about corruption and morality, when as a matter of fact, sila may utang, hindi binabayaran hanggang ngayon, and continue to occupy a land which is government, and which was not even sold to them validly. And yet they collect the taxes for all of those business establishments there. Na ano man itong Pilipinas, ha? Ako, hindi ako galit. Wala sa akin yan. I mean, I can be friends with them. I can say that, well, I'll just ignore it. But ABS-CBN, anak ka na? With Inquirer, keep on trashing the garbage that I had 200 million. But at that time, I was just a candidate. I challenged them. You are in power. Prove it. Open the books of all my accounts. I do not have that money. And if it is true that I have that money, I will withdraw from the candidacy of being president. Ngayon na presidente na ako, sabi ko, I am now the president. I am ordering everybody, every bank, to open your ledgers and show it to the public. Kasi kung may pera akong ganun, basi kalahati lang, I will gladly step down tomorrow. That is my guarantee. And if you may hear about my daughter, my sons, into corruption, especially with government transactions, just let it out. And I will also, I'm ready to resign from the presidency. I gave myself a very small window of committing errors. But I am also exacting sa mga taong may utang talaga. Lalo na yung may power. It's what ails the Philippines. Kasi ano tayo, yung not only forgiving but easily, yung usapan na lang natin to, sorry ah. Yung ganun, yung abuso ng pare. Yung kami sa Ateneo, ako, si Dominguez, labagka classmate kami niyan. Every time, you know, if you have, some of you guys are from, graduated from Ateneo, di ba every Friday may mass tayo? There's always a mass, then we go to confession, then we take communion. That is the regiments Ateneo. Well, yung Father Harry Falby, and it's you can open your it's not in the Facebook, what's on internet siguro talaga. You'll find his name there. He was the priest who was accused by 25 people from the Los Angeles area. And the Society of Jesus had to pay $25 billion. Gani, you look at his assignments. Last assignment would say there at Ateneo, Mindanao. He was there for us. Yung generations ko na tatlo pati yung generations ko sa baba. May tama talaga kami. And yet all the time, this social evil was just swept under the rug. And nobody wanted to talk about it. Pati kami, takot rin kasi akala namin it would be unjust. Na doon, what's your sin? Mortal lang pati venial eh. We don't even know how to classify it. So yung mga ganun, kailangan ilabas natin ang totoo. And not because I am a grandson of a Maranao woman. But you know, when Magellan landed in the Philippines and stayed here for 400 years and lived up with the fat of the land, sila, they brought along government, imperialism, and the religion. Ang problema sa kanila, because when they sighted Mindanao, they also wanted to conquer the island. But you know, 100 years, or at least I was reading the archives of Malaysia, at least 80 years before Magellan in 1521 landed somewhere in Leyte, Islam was already thriving in Mindanao. Kaya hindi mo makuha-kuha kasi may poste. And what is that poste? Islam. Mayroon silang rallying point. But during the Americans, because they had the gunpowder, they had the rifles, the 45s, so massacred dito, doon, kung saan na lang. Ang problema dyan sa Amerikano is we didn't have the cell phones and the mga camera noon. Sila mismo, sila ang kumukuha. Tapos, alam mo na, it's the history, it's in the archives. Some enterprising Filipinos got hold of it. And you can see the pictures of the massacres there committed and with the American soldier, his foot on top of the breast of a woman over the pile. But how can you reach a Mindanao, and maybe Visayas and Luzon was part of the Sri Visayas Empire. It was already Islam. As the Americans tried to force the issue, that's why they were able to control Mindanao because of the sheer force of arms. But they could not get workers, the Muslims, working there. Anong gusto nila? Logging, mining? So, they came up with the sloganeering, "Go to Mindanao because it is the land of promise." My father was a lawyer and single and went to Mindanao to try his luck. And well, of course, he met my mother. And I remember in 1948, we were brought there to Davao City. It was a hard life. And to think that at the time, Mindanao was already divided into so many cadastral lands. And they introduced the Torrens title, forgetting the originals there, yung mga Moro people. The Moro people, walang Christianos doon. Sure, if you're a Christian, you must have been there when you were young, or you are a descendant of the original frontiermen mo. Yung pumasok na doon. Most of them Ilocanos because they love to till lands and others. So, in a way also, without really demeaning the efforts of the Moro, what you see in Mindanao is really the sweat and toil of Christians. Ito ang problema ngayon. I've been able to convince the communists to talk. So this was a raucous konti-konti, but we were able to fix it and they are already talking again. Naano lang ako noon sa yung early premature patayan ng sundalo ko pati police. But, you know, you have to look at the bigger picture. I have succeeded in talking to the MILF kasi kaibigan kami. At marami akong mga pinsan doon, connect-connect na lang. And Miss Wari is also willing to listen to me. He's just crafting a sort of a BBL, parang counterpart sa MNLM. Sana kung, what would have been a great time for us? No more wars with the NPAs, no more killing, or at least there's a lessening now of really the violence. Wala na sanang rebellion sa mga... Itong rebellion ng MI pati MF is driven by nationalism. Lupa nila eh. So we just cannot say that we can kill, tapos na. Because after, if you go down to history, of course, it's Adam and Eve. If you believe in Adam and Eve, because the world, the planet Earth is 5 billion years old. So when was the right time for God to come down from heaven to say these things? At kung nakita mo yung carving ng mga tao doon sa caves, they were really like apes. So, anong itsura ni Adam pati ni Eve? And these are the things that yung mga myth natin, we have to correct it. We have to correct history. And I hate history. And geography natin, the first 5 pages talks about the discovery of the Philippines. And it's placed there, who discovered the Philippines? Magellan. Son of a bitch. Where did he come from? We were already good as a nation. The Malay race. Then they came to conquer us, stayed there for 500 years. Then by the Treaty of Paris, because there was a war between the Americans and the Spaniards, Marianas Island, Guam, Philippines, kaya pare-pare yung mga pangalan natin, were ceded to the Americans, and they stayed there for 50 years. So sabihin mo, directly sa exploitation of resources, tayo, no? Amerikano, the oldest mining company sa kanila. And even in Davao, there's still one. And itong mga bago ngayon, mga oligarchs, they just wait who wins the election. And because there's a law that says the Mining Act, they apply for. But nilagay ko naman si Gina, and she's very strict. Si Gina naman told me frankly, I want the Philippines to be mine-free. Come on, how can we do that? We have to amend the law. There's a mining law which allows mining. And besides, we get, on the average, $70 billion a year yan for its mining company. But I agree with Gina that kung maaari lang, hindi lang kasi nakita ninyo. You might want to go to Davao one of these days. I have a friend, Archie Po. He's in the business of leasing airplanes. I can borrow one. And you travel from Davao to Agusan to Surigao, maawa ka sa bayan mo. Maawa ka sa bayan. Parang tansan, yung tansan ng Coca-Cola na may cork. Ganun yan sa bukid. And even itong mga ordinaryong Pilipino, and it's not a tunnel thing, it's open pit. Kaya when it rains, pupundo yung tubig, and over time it loosens the bowels of the earth. So they have landslide and everything. There's so many injustices committed in thy name. And these are the guys who are really just there waiting for a job. I ordered the arrest of Jack Lam. Because he was given a sort of license there sa clerk sa gambling by President Aquino Corazon. And he was, 1% lang ang babayaran niya. 1% of the gross. And ito si Jack Lam was talking. Aabot kasi sa akin yan. The intelligence would mahagilap talaga nila yan. In Clark, he was talking as if everybody was in his pocket. So when I was reading the briefer one night, sabi ko, putang ina ka. Tinawagan ko yung aide ko. Sabihin mo sa NBI, arestuhin mo yung gagong yan. So there is no crime. Nobody. Kill him so that there will be a crime to solve. Kwarestuhin mo. Mabuti na lang nakasibat. Itong si Mighty Cigarette, he's a good guy. He's very magaan. And one time, itong syntaxes, tingnan mo talaga how they operate itong mga oligarch. Syntaxes, there was an increase of, you know, cigarillo, basta para to, anyway, to discourage, but it failed. But anyhow, you have to pay. So yung chairman ng Ways and Means was Ungab, the former congressman of the 3rd District of Davao. Itong si pangalan niya yawa nun. Yung in-check. Well, ako Lam rin ha, lolo ko Lam, baka mga... Kaya ko pinaresto yung si Lam, baka sabihin ng mga tao, kasi Lam eh. Si Wong, ano. Nag-usap kami, butit na lang, because the Class 67 ng PMA, inadapt ako as mista. Ngayon ang sakit nila. So siya, mista rin. So we were like classmates. We talked as if we were classmates and the PMA. Hindi ko nga na tapos ang ROTC ko nga. But anyway, pati sa akin, nag-usap kami. And he wanted me to talk to Ungab. So we look, I am not up to it. We're friends, but please, not, walk sa akin. I am simply not up to it. But when he left, may iniwan siya. But because there were also many Filipinos there in the restaurant, so I was busy answering question. Umuli siya, iniwan niya yung karton. Umalis na buong, sa tigtit-pagtindo pagbalik ko, sabi nitong aid ko, Bongo, may iniwan siya, no? Sabi ko, putang ina, tingnan mo, Bong, ano ito pera? Sabi ko, Bong, isa uli mo. And because it is, there is a camera there and you can check it. Sabi ko, sa nagsiselfon, isa uli mo sa putang ina niya. Pag hindi, ibuhos ko yan sa mukha niya. So, it can be, no, kasi makikita mo yan sa camera sa airport eh. And it's always recorded. Sabi ko, no, di ako tumatanggap ng, this is the way how they operate. And as of last count, 20 billion yung utang niya. We're paying fake taxes pa. No, it's not a question of, you know, it's not a question of evasion of tax. It's falsification. Yung stamp na fake. Every time you fake it, that's one crime. Oh man, how many packs of cigarettes you sold since then? How many is consumed by people smoking? Ano Pasko, nagpadala siya ng baril. Hindi ako mahilig niya. Ito ang problema. Itong ABS-CBN, ako, si Cayetano, isang grupo kami, there was literally no money. Until the last minute because I never went up sa ratings. 3-4, 3-4. Nobody gave me a Chinaman's chance to win even. So, I won. I won with about 6 million ang majority ko. So ngayon, if you should know me, huwag ka talagang pumunta sa akin ng pera. At saka kung ikaw may application ka sa gobyerno, may sulat na rekomendado ng politiko, consider it declined. Wala akong utang na loob. Ang congressman ko lang, si Aimee, kasi matagal ko nang kilala. I mean, matagal na kaming, Aimee has been governor for so long a time. Si Aimee, supported me, Abet Garcia, and a lady from Mindanao, and because of love. Yun lang ang totoo. Where love has gone, yung ganon. Pero I won there by about 100,000 ang majority ko. Bumaliktad siya eh. Kaya wala akong utang na loob. Kaya basi anong sinasabi ko, binubuga ko. Pag sinabi mo, putang ina ka mukha kang pera, Gabby Lopez ka, ikaw preto, putang ina. Nabubuhay kayo sa influence peddling. Tapos kung mga editorial ninyo criticizing corruption, wrongdoing, or anomalies, and yet kayo, ito sabi ko, ito yung mga oligarch. If you know her, tell her. Because talagang I will insist, it's now in the court. At sasabihin ko, do not force my hand into it. Kasi hindi talaga ako payag na babuyin ninyo ang Pilipinas. I am not promising you anything, but it's not about constitution. It's a piece of shit to me. Iganon-ganon mo ako sa mukha ko. It's all there. When I took my oath of office, I promised to God and to my countrymen that I will preserve and defend the Filipino people. Kaya the second promise was drugs. Kayong mga dreamers, mga libertarians, forget it. patay, there will be always patay. I will not stop until the last drug lord is killed and the last pusher is out of the streets. Because if I just kill the drug lord, the producer of Shabu, and there are runners there, there will always be someone tempted to cook Shabu because it is brisk business. Sabihin ng ikan, sabi nga ng simbahan, but Duterte is killing the also the poor people. But of course, to destroy Shabu in this country, I have to destroy the apparatus. I have to kill who's producing it and who is distributing it. One minus the other cannot do. You are dreaming. Killing? Well, I said to the policemen, go and hunt for them. And if it is possible, just arrest them. But if you are confronted violently, thereby placing your life in danger, then of course defend yourself and shoot the idiot. That is an accepted principle all throughout the world among policemen. That is how they operate. You just don't allow your policemen to sacrifice and commit suicide. So that's the way it is. My second promise, I will go after drugs. We have now 4 million addicts. Putang ina niya. 4 million addicts. This 3 million was during the time of General Santiago. The 1 million was during Bato's time. He breached the million mark by having one something. So 4 million yan. Here's the cuts. American experts, the forensics says that constant use of Shabu for 6 months and 1 year will destroy the brain of a person because it will shrink the brain. And when the brain is shrunk, what will I do with this Filipino? And ang sekreto niyang ganito, kaya ako takot, piskal ako eh. I'm a prosecutor. If you are drunk or out of your mind, when you kill a person, when you rape a child, which was very popular noon, ang bata nire-rape, binipick up lang, then destroyed body, yung mag-uwi dyan sa mga barangay-barangay, willied and dragged into a corner and rape and dies. Ganun ang Shabu. And if you are not in your right mind, not in complete control of your mental faculties, kung buwang ka, we cannot proceed against you criminally. If the doctor says, buwang man yan, tanungin mo ang pangalan niya, what's your name? Ah, nagsakay ako ng aeroplano. Ano? Bangag na. Mag-akyat ng mga bahay, mag-nakaw, magpatay ng lahat galing sa nanay, pati yung mga anak na babae, abusuhin, tapos patayin. Those were the days. Kaya delikado, and when you are now bringing him to court, as it, tanungin mo, at the time that you committed the crime, doctor, would you think that he was in his right mind? The doctor said, no, he was talking about hell, he was talking about the guardian angel ordering him killing his mother. So you cannot charge a person who is out of his mind. Na ngayon pag dito, he may have been in his complete faculties. But at the time of the trial, because of continuous use of Shabu, he's brought to trial. And if I were the defense counsel, I would just ask, Your Honor, may we have a preliminary hearing? Why? Just to determine whether or not my client can be prosecuted. And after so many questions, the doctor would always say the right thing, the truth. No, it's not. He's bangag. So he cannot be prosecuted. Now, if you review, take steps behind. If you review the last 5 years, 77,000 drug-related deaths. Sinong, who will pay for this? 77,000 patay. No, they're complaining about 10,000 dead. Make it 50, make it 100. Papatayin talaga kita. If I will not kill you, you will add to these statistics, and yet you do not go to prison because you are insane. Sinong managot nito ngayon? Who answers for this 77,000? Now, it's my time to administer the affairs of the country. I will not add anything to that 77 needless and useless deaths. I will kill you. When I was mayor of Davao City, do not destroy my city. We need to progress because I have 1.9 million. I have to build schools, pay the teachers, pay the police, make it clean, buy the medicines, and if Davao shrinks just like the years behind me, how do we survive? So do not fuck with my country. I will kill you. Do not destroy the young people of this country because they are our only assets. We are not millionaires, all of us. I don't think there's one here. When we are sick, dying, old, who pays for the hospitalization? Who mortgages their land, their acquired property, just to buy your... Who will bury you? Who will pay for the cemetery? Yan ang nakaproblema dyan sa droga. Hindi kami nagkakaintindihan ng human rights, pati itong libertarians. Just like Obama. Obama was a libertarian. But deep inside, in the recesses of his mind, he was really suffering from a deep inferiority complex. I don't know why. It shows in his language. Look what happened. It's almost a disaster. He started everything. Now it's getting out of hand because Trump is also something out of the blue. But all of these things were prolonged by, and he was talking as if he was only delivering sermons. And the mental structure was so many policies there about left, about leftist principles of governance. But something was terribly wrong with him. And even to chastise me, that prompted me to say, stop talking to me, reprimanding me, as if when I was mayor, I was already at the receiving end. But when I am president, do not just reprimand me publicly. If you have a complaint, you go to the United Nations. You file your complaint there and let the United Nations Human Rights Commission investigate me. When the report is there, then you begin to talk. And America has this habit of saying, either you stop this because you won't have the aid. We will stop your assistance. So I said, Mr. Obama, go to hell, son of a bitch. Why are you picturing as if you are throwing assistance there, enlisting us in a post. And sure enough that we cannot take a bite what you are. There's an idiom there. It's a Visayan idiom or cliche. Hindi kami patay gutom. Ibig sabihin, we will not die of hunger without you. I keep on repeating the State Department about aid, cutting. So I got pissed off. So what did I do? And I was surprised because as bananas, which made double rich, nobody was buying our bananas or pineapple. So I had to take a trip to China. And I had to ask President Xi Jinping, President, what's wrong with our products? It was of good quality before, but why are you rejecting it now? You do not want to import it. The pineapple. And he said, no, it's not, but it's about you always dovetailing the foreign policy of America. So it is no problem. I will separate. Now we are back. 100% of our banana exports is back. We lack what 70%. Because they stopped planting pineapple when there was no market, no export to China. Now that they are back of buying again, we are having a shortfall. Tayo ang walang supply, so we are dobing all the time. And China said, we will buy everything. You know, half of China is frigid the whole day, even on summer day. They need to... About 5 billion people need to eat. So that's the reality of our country. That's the history and my personal crusade. Corruption must stop. Drug must stop. Even for 5 years only. There will be a lessening, but you can be very sure that every centavo of your money will go for the benefit of the people of the Philippines. Sigurado yan. I assure you, as the sun will rise in the east, corruption will stop. I will not allow it. I have already fired one cabinet member and one close friend of mine who I said was with me since 1988 when I became mayor. The cabinet member, I am not used to humiliating people, but I really got pissed off because he was lying. Gentlemen, si ma'am, she is DSWD, she was there. So nakita talaga nung nabasa ko yung report. Because yung report niya galing sa legal officer niya mismo. At sabi ko, bakit ka pumunta doon to sign to buy a fire truck worth 18 million? Anong klaseng sunog yan? Mabarbay it at 7-8. That's the running price now of a fire truck made in Japan. This guy had to go to sign despite the fact that the opinion of his lawyer, the legal officer of his office, says do not defer. Just went tight to sign, and when I asked him during the cabinet meeting, I said, did you not read the... And he said, no, I was not furnished. I said, gusto kong sampalin, kaya lang, andyan man sila, ma'am. Sabi ko lang, you're fired. Go out of this office. I don't need you. So that is the price that you have to pay. I am hell-bent in stopping corruption and drugs. And whether or not I succeed remains to be seen. But kung sabihin niyo, because I mean that there will be no killings at all because of human rights, tell your story to somebody else. Because drugs will destroy our nation. 4 million na ngayon. Ilan pa ang madagdag? Another 2? Right? Or if you have a president o si son of a bitch, another 4, yeah. In 10 years' time, you will have a nation of parang walking dead. You saw it. It was only when I was president. I knew that it was a serious problem. In Davao also. Pero butit na lang sila. The warriors learned. They learned it the hard way. Do not, because I'll kill you. I will really kill you. No doubt about it. Ngayon, ang bayan ko, ang Pilipinas, eh, ako yung presidente. I'm supposed to protect you and your children. They keep on selling drugs there, just like in other places. America is one hell of a place. Drugs is also... That's why Obama kept on reprimanding me. But there's a tape of that because I made it public. When President Trump won, I called him as part of a committee. Courtos, even if you are like or you're dislike. So I said, Mr. President Trump, this is President Duterte. I would like to congratulate you on your victory. Said, oh, yes. Said, I've been expecting your call. And do not worry. Thank you. But if you are in Washington, give me a call. I will have coffee. Or if you're in New York. And besides, you're doing it right. And he said, this goddamn son there in the corner, and that just, he named the country. I will not name the country. They are pouring drugs there every day, so it makes Americans crazy. You're doing it right. So, which is really the best advice? The libertarian Obama? Or Trump? Of course, I agree with Trump because he agrees with me. That's the about power. The third is criminality. Must stop. And the abuses. The abuses against the military and civilians and police against civilians has to stop. I do not want oppression. Maybe it'd be better, even in the customs. There will be no opening of bags. You're just waved through. Anyway, when the cargo and the luggages are deplaned, it goes down to a bodega where there is a scanner, X-ray. So when you go up to a sort of an escalator conveyor, they already passed it. So if there is shabu, if there is a gun, you should be able to discern it while it is there because it passes a big camera. So when it's done there, lalo na yung OFW, kami, mga congressman, mayor, we are way by, may salute pa, even with a train of luggages. Here comes the OFW. Ako, may isa ako diyang insidente, no? Galing ako Hong Kong. Hindi na niya nakabalot kasi maliit lang eh. Dala-dala niya para sa... And we were late because I was waiting for this guy. Pinahirapan niya eh. Tinuturo niya doon sa kahiro. Hindi siguro sila nakaintindihan magkano. Sinabi ko sa kanya, Brad, bakit hindi mo pagbigyan liit-liit niya? Kami kanina, sabi ng custom, bakit, sino ka ba? Sabi ko, putang ina mo, sipain kita ngayon dyan. Sino ka? Sabi ko, bakit sinuka mo ako? Ikaw ang isusuka ko. Sabi ko, si Mayor Duterte ako nanda po. Kaya nga wala na. You go abroad, come in, there's no opening of the bank. No more. No more. I don't allow it. I don't allow anybody to touch the bugs. Leave it to the intelligence and the operation guys there because they would know if there's something brewing. But for those there in the... Alam mo, ito nang before I... It's 8 o'clock. Si Irap, naghihintay na yung buang birthday niya ngayon eh. Sabi niya, punta ka talaga ha. Kasi, tapos noon sabi niya, wala yan si Duterte, ano yan? Low class lang yan, ano yan, style niya, pagka ano. Ngayon, ano, balik kita sa kulungan. Ano ang makita mo sa akin? If you want to find fault, no? Money will take you forever. Women, they're all, matanda na sila. Pinatawad ko na sila, sabi ko, wala na. So wala, I sleep early. After eating, I sleep. Listen to the news. Pero ito ba, alam mo ba kung bakit hanggang ngayon, ano tayo? Because the Filipino takot sa mga police, pati military, pati mga customs. BIR, kailangan pa magdala sa customs, magbayad ka ba? Because you are not assertive of your rights. Look at the Americans. You just cannot fuck with them. They will shout at you. Oh, what's happening? What's wrong with my bag? Kayo dapat, pag magpunta yung mga BIR and you have paid and it is the correct amount, you shit him. Where the airport or you create a scandal because it would reach me and I will call him and I guarantee you, I slap him twice in your presence. One for me and one for you. Totoo. It's not a novel idea. I do it in Davao City for almost 23 years. And everybody behaves. So all you have to do is to be assertive. If you ask more than what you are required to pay, tell them, you better shut up or I'll slap you. And then he begins to heat up. Say, okay, you wait. I'll call President Duterte. And I have opened the television, PTV4. After the news, there's a 1 hour blank there. Because it says, you can text there. In this office, I followed up the papers and I was asked for the official. You name them. You need not give your name, but you name the official. Because I read it every day. And then I said, call the guy. And if I'm not satisfied, I said, either you resign or I'll file charges against you. Or better still, if you want, I've been doing it, I'll throw you over the Pasig River. It's just my... I'll tie your hands and feet and just drop you there. Alam mo ang Pilipino, pag hindi mo ganun yan, kung makiusap na would like to ask our countrymen to behave and let's work together. Puta na bilang, Ako bulahe na. Fuck you. Hindi mo madala ng story ng ganun. I said, remember, I am not I was not a rear and I was not northward in this kind of ambience sa Maynila na maraming mayaman. I do not come from an exclusive village. I am just trying hard just to My worry is really my Autobahn. When I said Duterte will declare martial law, what do you mean martial law? Declare the right of habeas corpus. I will not do that. I have this compressed to a simple phrase. It is my duty is to protect the Filipino nation. It be my term begins and ends with public service. Nothing behind, nothing more than it's there. And I will do it. I would know what power. And I said in the Abu Sayyaf, because there's an ASEAN meeting now, and they went there maybe to kidnap. It's a long drive, actually. And I told the Navy, if you see him, the boat, blast them off. Do not give me prisoners. I don't need them. If there is a fight and they surrender, you refuse, you decline the offer of surrender, let's continue fighting. But eventually, they will run out of bullets. I have plenty of soldiers to spare. I have acquired. Mayroon na tayo. We have a. Ibig sabihin ka? I will be. Before I go, we'll have about 16 F-50 jets. I'm using them. They're not supposed to be used during rebellion cases because of the. But I said, use them. And we've been using them. We're bombing. Either you stop. I've told the Mindanaoans here, you from Mindanao, because they are now putting IED, improvised explosive devices. That's what it is. Pati yung mga eskwilahan, Marawi State University, there was a grenade in the Sambuanga High School. And sinabi ko sa kanila, do not force my hand into it. I do not like it. Believe me. Do not force me to declare martial law. Because if I declare martial law for the Mindanao Island, then I will finish everything. Not only the insurgency or the rebellion, but every problem that has to be solved there. I will finish everything. I will solve all the problems for you. And it will really be harsh for everybody. And if I have to kill, I will not hesitate to do it. That's why I said, do not kill the young people. Do not place explosives in classroom. It's totally unacceptable to me. You do it on a daily basis, then you invite me to. Pag ako ang nag-martial law sa Mindanao, tapos ang lahat. Lahat na problema. Pati rebellion, lahat na. Lahat na kung anong makita ko ng gawin ko. Illegal mining and all, I'll just place you behind bars. And I do not give a damn what you said. Maraming illegal eh. Illegal fishing, mining, everything, spoiling our environment. Lahat tapusin ko yan. I said, not only, kaya sabi ko, do not overdo things because you will force my hand into it. And it will make you sad. Very sad. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank everybody for listening to storytelling. I was not making a speech. I know that, by your silence, because nobody was talking, you would know that you are already a bore because the guys at the back would chow, chow, chow. And you can hear there's a noise already. It means to say it should stop. But this, I consider this a privilege to give me to talk to you, because from here on you would know how to spin the story of war or history, so that you can place it in a proper perspective right away, that this is the situation. And I studied in Ateneo, so was my brother, and I graduated from a Catholic school, San Beda. So, holy kami. Ako holy talaga ako. Sumubra lang yung pare. Akala mo wala silang kasalanan. May mga ka mag-anong ka na. Bless. Yung ano, they don't really use the confessional box. You'll pull a chair, say, come, sit there. So, what's your sin? Then you begin to, is it venial or mortal sin? Mortal sin, nalga. Venial purgatory. Now, tell me. Listen, I went to the room of the helpers. Oh, why did you go there? What did you do? I lifted the blanket, and because I wanted to see what's inside. And you lifted? Yes, ah. Nothing else? I went out further. Then he would start to fondle you. What else? I went back to the room further and lifted the blanket higher. And I went to the bathroom after. Oh, what did you do there? You. Yes. Do it every day, every night? Almost every night, brother. Lahat naman eh. Mga pare, pero ginahawakan kami. That, go into that internet. There's Harry Falvey. The brothers, they're both sued. Pare sila sa Society of Jesuits. Tingnan mo kaano. Both of them were charged. And wala naman sila, patay na. A lot of, but we, the students of, he passed, at I don't know if he was stayed long in Zamboanga and Cagayan. There are Jesuits there. Ateneo, Zamboanga, Cagayan, pati Davao. But it's good to show to the public. And this endless debate about heaven and hell. Kaya ayaw ko gusto yung Katoliko. You know, when you talk about a religion and you threaten small children going to hell and picturing it as a place where everybody is burning, that's not religion. That's coercion. And that is what drove the nomads in the desert before. What they can think of is how do we convert this guy and how do we make him follow. So that's hell. There's no such thing as hell. Hell is here. I said we have about, they say that the earth is 5 billion years old. So at what time did Jesus Christ really come down to save the, how about the last 400 billion, nothing happened to their lives because there was no God. I do not agree. You know, I ran because I decided to run. I didn't have the money until the last minute. When my rating was hitting 34, that's the time that the money came in. But most of the time, I rent a Cessna model 1984. Nagko-conk out once we lost its brake, mabuti sa Davao. Walang brake, diretso-diretso na doon sa tubig. So because I have no money, I only rent, I was able to rent the cheaper ones. But I said, I want, was it really a price? Well, I don't know. I could not, the plant, every now and then conks. Going to summer, it conk out the transponder. So that is my, it's not a sad story actually. It's story about a guy who really was looking for trouble when there was none. I was supposed to retire. And problem because my daughter would not run for mayor. Kung hindi siya tumakbo ng mayor, hindi talaga mag-presidente. I still have my last term, then pa-retire na ako. But at the last, she was the one who wrote me publicly not to run because I will just be used by, you know, politicians. But when she said, you run, and she agreed to, you know what? We took her out of office June 30, 31. It's in the Malacañang office. If you happen to go to Malacañang, ang Gaga resigned after July 1, nag-submit ng resignation ko, talagang Gaga. You know my daughter, the one who mold the sheriff, yung binugbog niya yung sheriff na ganun yung babae na yan. But kung wala na kayong makuha ng ibang presidente, yan ang kunin ninyo. Patay lahat. Ubos yan. Noon, yung dagdag puser lang, pati butika owner dyan, patay na. Ibang klase ng babae na. So I live with a sense of gratitude that you kept with me all the time to listen to stories. But that is good, an example of how things are in the Philippines. We are run by oligarchs. Yung walang capital. Like Ong Pin. Ong Pin has been alive since Marcos. Anong capital ng putang ina niya? Influenza. So every time who wins there, he will just go, say his friend. Di, kasi liberal lang pati ano eh. Dito buko sila. Nasira sila. Hindi mo sila makalapit sa akin. And I don't allow people. Kung kayo pa, ordinaryo, aho. But the dinner there is simple. I'm not joking. No more steak. It's a one viand, one soup. Ayan, matangin si mama. Sa cabinet meeting, our dinner is one soup, one viand, or piece of rice. Yun lang. I can invite you, but you have to, I don't know if it's to your liking ang maulam. Because I do not throw parties there because it's not our money. Iba yan kung pera ng inyo yun eh. Mahirap na, lalo na kung hindi kayo kasali sa kainan. So salamat po at congratulations.